The Milwaukee County District Attorney is conducting a secret investigation that seems to focus on individuals with ties to Governor Walker. The John Doe was included in an FBI raid on the Madison home of a senior Walker aide and the granting of immunity to another top aide. The governor has said he doesn't know what the investigation is about, and since authorities can't comment, speculation abounds. Does any of this threaten to hurt Walker politically? We're asking J.R. Ross of WisPolitics.com, an editorial partner of Upfront. J.R. is at our Madison affiliate, WKOW-TV. J.R., thanks very much for being with us. Let's talk for a moment about whether this has become a distraction. The John Doe, has it become a distraction for Governor Walker and the Walker administration?
Well, it's not going to derail his initiatives or his agenda. It is, though, going to be an annoyance. Whenever he goes out to Green Bay or Eau Claire, La Crosse to talk about jobs, he's going to be asked about John Doe as well. It's just kind of a fact of life because these stories keep popping up. It's going to be have a presence going forward whenever he's out in public talking about his agenda.
A lot of people are trying to connect the dots here. They see departures by key Walker staffers. They see these legal developments occurring, and they say somehow they're all connected. Is it possible they're not connected?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, there are good reasons why Keith Gilkes has left Walker's administration as the chief of staff to go back to the campaign. There's a recall election possibly coming next year. There's a good reason why John Hiller, a longtime Walker confidant, would leave the campaign, only be treasurer, to go leave that position to somebody who's more trained in that kind of work. But politics is a perception game, and the perception is all these things keep popping left and right, so they have to be connected in people's minds. And with nothing, with no concrete proof from the DA's office yet, or charges, or anything that people can put their hands on, people fill the vacuum, and that's what happens in politics. So there's people going, okay, well, how does this all relate? What's going on? What's happening here? And that's why it's a problem for Scott Walker.
It's the drip, drip, drip phenomenon, right?
Yeah, I mean, this would be much better for Scott Walker if it all came out in August, basically, right after the recall elections were done for the state Senate. Get it all out in August, have all the charges come down, if there are going to be any, and get it out of the way, be focused back on what he wants to do. You know, if the worst thing for Scott Walker is have this thing pop like December, January, February, when people are taking out petitions to recall him and try and force him out of office next year. That's only going to add fuel to that fire and make it, life more difficult for him.
Real briefly, JR, what's the political spin on this? What are Democrats saying? What are Republicans saying?
Republicans keep saying, look, at best, this is a couple of rogue people on Walker's county staff who went out there and did some stuff they shouldn't have been doing. Democrats are just as happy as can be about it because, like, look, Governor Doyle was the most investigated governor that we've ever had. And you never had an FBI agent going through, knocking on his aide's doors on a early morning with a battering ram poised and knock the door down to get evidence. This is bad for Scott Walker, and we're going to get everything out of it we can.
J.R. Ross from WisPolitics.com. Good to have you back on the program. Thanks very much for being with us.
Anytime.
Next, Occupy Wall Street protests coming to Wisconsin. Is it the birth of a movement?